Hey guys, welcome back to Smartphone World. Lenovo unveiled Moto G5S and G5S Plus last week. I will leave the link to buy the phone in description from Amazon in case if you are interested. In this video, let's do a full camera review of Moto G5S Plus. The camera department is where all the difference lie between Moto G5S Plus and the older G5 Plus.
Moto G5S Plus comes with 13 megapixel dual rear camera with color corrected dual LED flash.
The second camera also has the same 13 megapixel sensor but does not have a color filter and can only see in black and white. Because of the lack of the color filter, the second sensor can capture more light and more detail in theory. At front, you get 8 megapixel f2.0 selfie camera with flash that takes pretty good selfies and can also record full HD videos. The camera app is very similar to Moto G5 Plus and it is pretty simple. You get Pro mode where you can control every setting in the camera app, 4K video recording and slow motion recording at 720p. Coming to the camera quality, at broader daylight, the camera takes excellent picture with great amount of detail. But at night, camera suffers from noise due to lack of OIS. The same goes for video as well. During daylight, the videos are great with lots of detail and contrast, but at night, camera suffers from noise and overexposes some areas. You can use the second camera's depth sensor to capture images with background blur. To enable depth mode, you have to click the depth effect button on the camera app. Once captured, you can use some editing tools to adjust the intensity of the background blur, discolor the background and even replace the background with another image. As far as the depth effect goes, we had mixed results, and the camera struggled to apply the effect to most of the objects. One unfortunate problem with the camera is that it is slow. This could be due to both the sensors working together and the hardware just not capable enough to process all that information fast enough. Turn on HDR or night mode and things drag on even further. The worst offender by fast is the depth effect, which takes a solid 5 to 6 seconds to capture the image and process the image once you hit the shutter button. Lenovo needs to bring down this time further if it intends on anyone using this feature seriously. The biggest talking point on the G5 Plus is the dual rear camera on the back. While we think the image quality of regular still photos at daylight is good, the depth effect left a lot to be desired, both regarding actual quality of the images and the time required to process the image. If you are buying Moto G5S Plus mainly for camera, then you will get only above average experience. The hardware is great, but Moto needs to get the software right to improve the overall quality of the camera. So what do you guys think of Moto G5S Plus camera? Share your thoughts on the comment section. If you like the video, hit the thumbs up button and subscribe to Smartphone World for more tech and gaming videos. As always, thanks for watching the video. I will see you guys in the next one. You guys have a great day.